I wondered who my friends were. I thought there must be quite a few. I found I had no friends, dear, till I go dreaming of you.
Hello, friends, and welcome to the Bone Zone Friendly Hour. I'm Brendan Walsh. With me here is Randy A. Lidke.
Hello, Bone Zone listeners.
Hi, Randy. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you, Brendan?
I'm great. You know why I'm feeling great?
Why?
Because we just recorded a top-notch Bone Zone podcast, episode number 65.
Oh, yeah. I was there, and I can't deny that what you said is true.
It's totally true. So if you're listening right now, if you have headphones, it's the best way to listen to this because you get all the deep tones and highs and the mid-range. So put on your headphones, toke up a big fat doobie. Am I right, Randy?
Dude, I think you're totally right. Yeah, totally.
This is Bone Zone episode 65. And boneheads, don't forget, go to bonezonepodcast.com and you can order the last remaining t-shirts with our old Bone Zone logo. They go for $23 plus shipping. They're going to be worth thousands pretty soon because they are out of print.
Yeah, totally.
And you can also buy buttons from our friend Don at friendprices.com. They're also advertised on bonezonepodcast.com. You get a set of buttons for only 10 bucks, limited edition. This is all collector's item stuff, you stupid bitches.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can check out my website, brendanwalsh.com, BrendanWalsh.com.
Oh, yeah.
WALSH.com. Follow me on Twitter, Cinnamon Bun.
Follow me too, Cinnamon Bun, or Cinnamon Roll, Randy Lidke.
That's R-A-N-D-L-I-D.
Follow us on Twitter.
Tacoma, if you're in Tacoma, Washington, I'm going to be there the last weekend this month, March 28th through the 31st, possibly. Go to brendanwalsh.com and you can see all my tour dates up through like May or something. For now, sit back, relax. Put on your headphones, brew yourself a cup of chai tea, and listen to Randy, Johnny Pemberton, rare appearance from Johnny Pemberton on the Bone Zone and me.
Why must we live like this? Love is not a plaything. This must be the real thing. Will the dawn bring you near? And so, dear, when the day breaks, and I must be.
Damn! That's the kind of tuna that I like. Bum, 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 bum.
Tuna?
That's the kind of tuna I like. Ooh, baby.
Sometimes the world looks perfect. Nothing to rearrange. Sometimes you just get a feeling like you need some kind of change. No matter what.
Oh,
Is anything going to stop you guys?
Nothing. Nothing will stop me.
Hey, boneheads! Listen up, boneheads! You've just stepped into the Bone Zone with me, Brendan Walsh, and these old Rand Man, Randy Litke.
Welcome to the Bone Zone.
Shine bright like the Rand Man. Shine bright like the Rand Man. And hey, Rand Man, why don't you tell the boneheads listening who our special guest today is?
Hello, listeners. Our special guest today is good friend of mine and yours, Johnny Pemberton.
Black as the night is long.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know what Johnny looks like, he's a black dude.
black dude.
He's a black teenager.
He's a teenage black guy.
I'm a black dude. Hey, I'm a black dude.
Shining bright like a black dude.
What is that? What's that?
That's a Rihanna song.
Oh,
Shine
Rihanna.
Bright like a diamond.
Oh, Rihanna.
Rihanna.
I don't like that song.
Do you know why I bought this coconut water? This is not
because you're from the islands, man.
No, this is the one that she does not endorse.
Oh, does she endorse all the other
she
ones?
She endorses Vita.
Vita Mix?
She endorses
Vita
Coke.
I want to get one of those Vitamix blenders.
I bet you do.
I'm fucking getting one.
They're expensive, man.
I know.
Beware.
They can be like $800.
Yeah, buyer beware.
Really?
But they say that you can boil water in them or something. They spin so fast that the water will heat up. So if you just want to make soup, throw everything you want in there.
I heard that.
Turn it on for a little while and you got hot soup.
You just put tomatoes in, it cooks them, and you can add cheese later.
And then you got a pizza right there. You got a drinkable pizza.
Uh-huh. I heard what you do is you put pizza dough in the blender.
No.
Put it in, and you just turn it on, and come back a couple hours later, and the pizza's...
You got yourself a deep dish pizza pie.
The Vitamix gets so hot that it heats up the counter, and you can squirt flapjacks on the counter.
Oh.
And you can actually cook a pizza if you got cupboards underneath. Where you have the Vitamix, it turns those cupboards into an oven. So make sure you don't got any pets in your cupboards
or your
like
baby.
I don't know if you guys know about this, but sometimes where I'm from, like a hot summer in Brooklyn,
Johnny,
you can cook an egg on the sidewalk.
Oh like, yeah,
that's what we would do growing up. You know, like it's so hot, really? So you cook an egg.
Look, hey yo, my phone number starts with 917. Hey, give me that egg. I'm going to cook it on the asphalt over here because I'm from Brooklyn. Go Yankees. Am I right?
917-386-6962.
Yeah, that's Johnny's.
917.
That's like the phone number to Diet Pepsi or something.
917-386-6962. He's got a good bass. He's got a falsetto.
Yeah, Randy, you're a true bass with a killer falsetto.
Coming up next, you guys seen him on Premium Blend. You've seen him on Down Under Hot Shot Splendor. He's got a true bass with a killer falsetto.
Guys, I'm not sure if that's true.
Got a killer bass. We can falsetto. Killer bass.
Yeah.
We can falsetto.
Oh my god.
Killer bass.
We can falsetto.
Killer bass. Get down.
Killer bass.
We can falsetto.
Killer bass. Killer bass. Look at that. Hey, Randy, when you did that just now, mm-hmm. it really surprised me. I was taken aback at how cartoonishly that sounded. It's almost like, what's that song where it's like,
shine bright like a diamond.
Bump that bass.
When he's really low?
Yeah, when you're like.
Yeah, I can go pretty low. Oh. I was in a limbo contest with my voice one time.
Oh.
Do you ever listen to Sha Na Na? That Bowser dude, he really has a bass.
Really?
But yeah, let's listen to some
Sha Na. How about the Clovers? You ever listen to the Clovers?
It was St. Patrick's Day recently, so I'd like to send a shout out to all the drunken idiots wearing green.
You're an Irishman.
I'm an Irishman.
But you're not, Randy.
Dutch, Irish, Scotch, French, and German on my father's side.
God, I'm not Irish at all. I have none.
What are you?
English.
English?
Yeah.
Yeah, I figured.
And French. And German.
Which Sha Na Na song?
Good Night, Sweetheart. Or good, I don't know how it goes.
Okay. Oh, I can do that.
Good night.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Hey, I got one for you, Randy.
Blue Moon, too.
I got a seriously good song for you to do a bass thing for. It's a song called That Chick's Too Young to Fly by Johnny, what's his name? Johnny
Pemberton?
Johnny Bragg. Johnny Bragg, yeah.
You want me to look it up?
Seriously.
What is it called?
That Chick's Too Young to Fry.
Chick's Too Young to Fry. Okay, here's Blue Moon by Sha Na Na while we wait.
Blue Moon.
Oh, you can hear him in the background.
Yeah. Bowser was always like famous for that. You just hear him in the back of every song go, yeah.
Ooh, yeah. You know that guy?
No.
Wow, Randy. Wow.
I can't do it. I can't get that low. I'm trying to get that low. I can't get that low.
Chicks Too Young to Fry by who?
Johnny Bragg.
I'm finding it by Louis Jordan.
Louis Jordan, suck my buck. Suck my jag.
By
Jag my suck.
Jag. It's probably too obscure for YouTube.
Hey, if you're a first time listener, don't change the channel.
It's probably a little too obscure.
What's the guy's name again?
Johnny Bragg.
Johnny
Bragg and the Prisoners. He's a blind inmate.
Oh, and the Prisoners. Memphis. That one was on there.
Okay, sorry.
Okay. You ready?
You're gonna like this, Randy.
Hey, man, guess what? Good. What's that, Pops? I met a chick. Oh, yeah, what kind of chick? Real chick.
Yeah.
How old is she?
16.
16? Yeah. Man, are you crazy? No, listen to me.
Tell me something.
This sounds like Louis Jordan. That's probably why he covers
boy,
it.
Hey, boy, don't you
go.
That bird. Don't you dare.
16. Oh, way down there.
Start releasing that chick.
Hear that bass?
Get a licking. That chick's too young to fry.
You sing it, Randy.
Say, boy, better take my word.
Sounds like a fucking saxophone.
Why? No.
Feed her steady till she gets rid of that chick's too young to fry. Take her back to the barnyard.
Grand man.
Way out there in the barnyard.
All you listening, we're coming to you live from South by Southwest in Austin, Texas, checking out all the good new bands. You heard some Sha Na Na. This is, what's the name of this band again?
Johnny Bragg and the Prisoners.
They
just got signed to Decca.
All the awesome up-and-coming bands are here. Sha Na Na, Johnny Bragg.
Tough Ones. Lickshot. The Guarantors. They were great. You see, the Guarantors last night, that was a great band.
I saw them at the Cactus Cafe.
Oh, wow.
Last night. It was
I
so
missed
great.
That.
And then there was an after party.
At Jack's or at Sparrow's?
Jack's.
I can't
remember. They were both, yes. But I don't know. I'm so drunk the whole time I'm here.
They had that shared door, right? Yeah.
Yeah, you go in the one door, it's Jack's, and the other one, it's Sparrow's.
I know. Austin's funky, man. It is
Austin
a funky,
is funky
town.
Yeah.
It is funky.
I mean,
funky town.
There's all this stuff about keeping it weird, but they're doing it.
They keep it funky.
Yeah.
They should change the name of Austin to Funky Town.
Funky Town.
Won't you take me to
Funky Town? Or how about...
Won't you take me to...
Mm-hmm. You know what I do when I'm at South by Southwest? I don't choose where I go by the music. I choose where I go by the barbecue.
I was about to say that.
And guess what? The music finds me. Okay?
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm introduced to things I never knew of, because I'm choosing barbecue over music. And guess what? My music has now like expanded because of it.
Barbecue is a music.
Oh, very good. Barbecue is a
it
music.
It is a music. I think there's a musicality to barbecue.
Oh, God. It's like there's because there's so many like little notes mm-hmm. and like oh, there's yeah. like a sharp mm-hmm. note here and then like mm-hmm. a minor little note in the sauce.
Pardon me for blowing your minds. Barbecue is an art.
Oh, barbecue oh, dude, is an art. Yes.
No question about
definitely.
It. No, I know that.
It's an art.
Those of you listening, we are live at South by Southwest.
Southwest Music Festival.
We're at the Austin Convention Center. We're here
off?
In front of a live crowd.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's up, everyone?
Hey.
Live.
Oh, it's Luke. What's up, Luke?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah. It's Luke Burbank.
Live, Austin, Texas, South by Southwest. Tonight, for those of you still here, is Midnight Show. Chubby Checker's going to be playing.
No way. He's yep. still alive. I forgot about
yeah.
that.
Yeah. No, he's...
Everyone thought he was dead.
That was a rumor. That was like yeah. Paul McCartney. Mm-hmm. Do we have a little Chubby Checker that we could...
No, Chubby Checker is a ripoff artist.
Yeah, he ripped off the Big Bopper.
He did. The Big Bopper died. I wonder why. Because Chubby Checker changed the fuel lines out in that plane. Killed
That's
him.
Right. He hooked the fuel line up to the soda... fountain.
That case is still open, actually. It is.
Really?
The case of soda and that case in the courts.
Soda versus... Oh, here we go. You can hear in the background, that's Chubby Checker warming
oh,
up
wow.
for the big show tonight.
Oh my God, he
come
still sounds...
Come on, baby!
He still sounds just as good as the day I first saw him.
Oh, dude, he's so good.
It's like a velvety, cheesy taste.
Hey, Chubby, why don't you play something else for a change, all right?
No, keep playing that, Chub.
Yeah.
What's ooh. He playing now?
Oh. On,
what is it?
Oh, this is a different new song.
Oh, you're looking good. Oh,
okay.
That's awesome.
I'm going to sing my song. All right.
What a good voice.
So good. Wait a minute.
What?
Let's
twist again. Twist again?
That's a new song.
No, wait. Oh, this I get it.
Let's twist again, okay.
If you out there, if you've never been to South by Southwest, this is where it's all happening. We got Chubby Checker, we got Sha-na-na.
Canvas bags. The band and the actual canvas bags.
And you get a free canvas bag when you purchase a wristband.
I got three.
Hey Chubby, do you have anything that's not about the twist?
Yeah, this is gonna be such a huge show. Thanks. We'd like to
oh, wow,
thank JoJo's Coffee Shop for supplying.
Oh, wait a second. I thought you just asked for... Uh-huh.
I thought you said not... Nothing twist related,
hey, Chubby. Chubby,
nothing twist... Yeah, I said nothing twist related.
Yeah,
right?
Maybe he just heard twist and was like...
So
he
strange.
Might have thought you said more twist related songs.
Did he just say twist train?
Twist train?
It's different.
I'm sorry, but this is just night train with for twist in place of night.
Twist train. Chubby, nothing about twist.
Yeah, enough twist... Now we're talking.
All right.
Yeah. This reminds me of like a really good bottle of Sprite. Yeah.
That's good.
I like this.
See, you don't have to be about the twist, Chubby. Just do what you want.
Well, I'm sorry.
Slow twisting? What the fuck?
I mean,
Chubby.
Fuck you, Chubby Checker.
Chubby, he's a fraud. Chubby. I never realized all of his songs were about twisting.
What an
idiot. He's
got
to have one non-twisting song.
Let's
Chubby,
see.
Get the fuck out of here.
Chubby,
get on your fucking checkermobile and get the fuck out of my face. Hey, Chubby, you're not so fat anymore.
Hey, Chubby, suck on my Chubby. But you
got it. He's going to die tomorrow. We're going to be sad.
This is pretty good. I don't think this is even about like a dance or anything. Oh, you do the shimmy. Hey, let's do the shimmy. All right.
Well, it's different than twisting. midnight show here in Austin. Are you the live audience? Are you guys gonna go see Chubby Checker tonight at the Austin Music Hall? Yeah.
Man, what a hot place.
Oh, dude, this town is jumping. You know, it is funky town. I'm going to officially rename. What do you guys think? Audience, what do you think if we officially start calling Austin Funky Town? What do you think about that?
Funky Town.
Well, I guess they don't like that.
Take me to the funky town. Oh, man, listen to that carousing going on. The hot dog vendors.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, is that raining? Oh, it's claps. I love it.
So we're here at the Austin Convention Center. Randy, so you just joined a band while we were out here.
Yeah, there's a band that they didn't have a drummer. Yeah. And I actually don't know how to play drums. So they did,
matter.
I sit in a chair and I just play my lap.
Yeah. Cool.
And I slap the lap and it keeps the beat, and that's, you know, that's all I can
slap
do.
Slap the lap and keep the beat.
Gotta slap the lap and keep the beat.
You gotta slap the lap and keep the beat.
You gotta slap the lap and keep the beat.
Gotta slap the lap and keep the beat.
You gotta slap the lap and
keep the beat.
You gotta slap the beat. Slap the slap
and keep the beat.
Slap your flap. Gotta slap your slap and clap your flap and nap your nap and take a nap, and then you flap your clap and shake your clap and then the beat. Keep it up, slap your lap and keep the beat. Gotta slap that lap, keep the beat. Gotta slap your lap and keep the beat.
Gotta slap that lap and keep the beat.
Gotta slap your lap and keep the beat.
Gotta slap that 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 lap and keep the beat. Gotta slap that lap and keep the beat.
Slap your lap and keep the beat. Wow, man, South by Southwest.
It's all music all the time here, live, South by Southwest, Bone Zone, coming at you. We're going to play a little something from a new up-and-coming band called The Crickets.
Is that the one that the Jason Sex started?
Jason Sex.
Or is it just Jay Sex, right? Jay Sex, you know him?
Jay Sax or
no,
Jay Sex?
Sex.
Two different people.
It's J-A-Y-S-E-C-K-S, Jay Sex.
Oh, I don't know. I never heard of it.
Jay Sex and the Butt Grooms.
Say it one more time.
Jay Sex and the Butt Grooms.
One more time. I didn't hear you.
Jay Sex and the Butt Grooms.
Grooms. How do you spell that last part?
I think it's G-R-O-A-M-S.
G-R-O-A-M-S.
I think it's him. Unless it was cursive. I read in cursive. Jay Sex and the Butt Grooms. You've heard them, right? I thought it was a friend of yours, Brendan, right? Jay Sex?
Jay Sex and the... I know Jay Sex. I don't know about the Butt Grooms.
The Butt Grooms. That's like his band. It's like a 16-piece group he rescued from the Tuareg people in Africa because they're under civil war. So he hauled them over here, set them up in a real nice apartment.
Oh, I saw the documentary about that.
Yeah. I saw a documentary how they're displaced. They're like weavers.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's, I guess that's the word groom come from. Crumb. The word grom crumb from, sorry, the word grom crumbs from, shit, I'm sorry.
That's all right. Let's do it again.
The jerk brom some from.
Take it again. Shit, I could edit all that.
Yeah, we'll edit all this
okay. I'm just having trouble. I had so much coffee. Yeah, well, the jom from snom clum, the word.
Frink.
The word that is there, Fred.
Okay.
Is the.
You're back on track. You're back on track. You're back on track. You're fine. You're back on track.
J-Sex.
J-Sex went over to the Tuareg people of Africa. Right. Mm-hmm. The same people that named that guzzling VW after.
Yeah.
Grass guzzling. Jazz buzzling.
Okay.
The jazz buzzling.
Jazz buzzling.
Jazz buzzling.
Graham Frunk.
And so that bird comes from.
The Graham Frunk.
That Grom bird.
From.
Oh my God. I keep messing this up. The bird shums clum. That germ comes from the firm word or the weaver's word.
What? I didn't catch the last part. You had it until the very last part. You just messed up, I think.
The skirt hums dumb. The reason that they are from Africa, 16-piece ensemble band, they do a weave. They're weavers.
Mm-hmm.
And the grom crumbs from, mm-hmm. the word grom mm-hmm. crumbs from the I can't remember. I think I need to make an appointment with my doctor. Yeah, that's it. That's a classic Grom right there.
Is this a Grom?
I think it's a Grom. It's on that label Stoma Home. Stoma Home?
Stoma Home?
It's all sounds of people's stomas.
Oh, okay.
So you're Stoma Home.
So,
you like the middle toe, right?
You do, give me those scrimps to suck on. Yeah, suck on your toes.
Stop it.
He likes that. He likes come that on, second Randy, to the second to the pinky.
You guys
huh?
want to see us suck Randy's toes or not? Come on. You guys, what are you saying? Me and Johnny are going to suck Randy's toes right here live South by Southwest. Come on, Randy. Take those socks off, baby.
Sixth Street is nuts. Isn't Sixth Street crazy?
Okay. Sixth Street, Austin, right. Texas.
I just say it. Okay. All right.
Ooh, oh, yeah. Those wool socks. Those wool socks.
All right, be careful, though. I'm sickleish.
Randy, you need to get some sun.
I know. Sorry.
Brendan, have you seen a pale that toe before?
A pale toe.
There's some pale scrimps right there.
I wear socks even with sandals. That's just the type of guy that I
should
am.
Should we do rock, paper, scissors to see who gets to go first?
Oh, I think so.
Okay.
I think three rounds. Ready?
Okay. Ready? One, two, three.
No. It's not, you go one, two, show,
and then
right?
Three. Okay, yeah. One, two, show.
I win that one.
Okay. One, two, show.
Tie.
One, two, show.
Ooh. So it's 1-1.
1-1.
Best of three.
Okay. One, two, show.
Ooh, tie.
One, two, show.
Tie again.
One, two, show. I got you.
Oh,
I get
my
to go
God.
First. I'm going to go first, Randman.
RPS.
Which should I start with, left or right foot?
Oh, I would say...
Let's let the people choose.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, everybody in this audience, do you want me to suck on Randy's right foot first? Round of applause.
Oh, my okay. God.
Now, who wants me to suck on the left foot? Round of applause.
Oh, wow.
Everybody wants me to start with your right foot.
That's
wow.
crazy.
It's crazy. Not one person. Nobody?
So quiet, too.
I'm right-handed and right-footed, so I think maybe that's
so this
why.
Will be a more toned foot.
Hey, I'll tell you right now.
Better foot.
Pardon me. I'm jealous.
Yeah, I know. Well, you get the left foot. I won't touch the left one.
Well, the left one is clearly not as good. It's not going to have that stank that the right one does.
We'll just have the people vote again. They'll see.
No, just go. Just do it. I don't care.
All right.
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Can we get one of these live bands to play some toe-sucking music?
Care.
Is there any, maybe like a foot?
Maybe like 10,000 Maniacs.
But they have a toe sucking
What about the
song?
Band that goes, do-na-na-na-do, do-na-na-na-do, I want to suck a do-da-do. I want to suck toes because Randy's toes really know how to fly. I'm sucking on a toe, a bigger little toe, a middle one in my mouth. I want to suck toes. I want to suck them like a Brendan's Walsh. What song?
I don't know that tune.
Sounds
really familiar.
It's probably a hit.
It is. It's like a big old Jewish hit.
Oh, yeah. It's one of those Jew songs.
One of those Jewish hits. It's like an American Idol song, I think. Kelly Clarkson and the Clarks?
Speaking of Clarks, the Dave Clark Five's here, too. South by Southwest. Mm.
And also, it's funny because so is Dave Brubeck.
Oh, really?
His whole band, even though he's died.
Well, that's, you know, there's a lot of bands go on once the guy dies.
You ever heard that song, Take Five?
No. We'll listen to it. Maybe should we listen to that while I suck on Randy's feet?
That'll be funny because how many toes do you have, Randy?
I have five on each foot. I have five toes on each foot. 10 toes total.
So if you played Take Five, it'd be appropriate because it's like Brendan's going to take all five and put them in his mouth.
I'm going to put your whole foot in my mouth at once, Randy.
It's going to be like a shrimp cocktail.
It's like a scrimped cocktail.
It's like a scrimp cocktail inside of a cocktail glass.
Oh, dude. I just love sucking on fucking dudes' toes.
You want fucking dudes?
No, dude.
I got a chip lodged.
Chip lodged? Oh, I love that band.
Chip Lodge.
They're not here at South By.
How about Garrison Brunch? Do you know him?
Garrison Brunch? No.
Yeah, he's new. He's an electronic artist. He's
Is he like a young mulatto teen?
Yeah, he's good buddies with James Pants.
Okay, I've seen him, yeah.
Yeah. Or, I mean, you can't be J-Sex. Simple as something that nobody knows
it. Her eyes are as big as her right. bubbly toes on the feet. Oh, come on. Don't be shy, Randy.
Jack Johnson's here for you to suck on my toes.
Jack.
Yeah, it's live from South by Southwest. We got Jack Johnson playing here on 6th Street
hey,
while
Brendan,
I suck on Randy's toes.
Why don't you stop talking and start sucking? All
right, here we go.
Oh. Oh my god. I'm gonna narrate this. Okay. Vernon's paying some deep attention to that pinky right now. He's got that pinky. little tonsil wrangling right there.
There you go, all the way in.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I haven't seen this kind of action since Dr. Scholl's. This is like Dr. Scholl's right here.
Oh, wow.
Look at this.
That feels actually good. It feels really good.
What are you doing?
Tell me what you're doing.
It
feels really good.
I'm putting my tongue between your toes and putting it out. Look, watch.
I can't even see that. That's what I can't see it. Jesus Christ.
You like that, Randy? You like that? Okay, I'm done. I'm just gonna kiss him now.
Oh my god, Brendan. I don't think I wanna suck
on him. I'm gonna kiss to the beat. Ready?
Such a good song. That is a good song. What was that?
Jack Johnson, Bubbly Toes, man.
But it's got such a groove to it. It's like...
Oh, God, he's so chill.
Have you guys been to lately? Mm-hmm. I went there recently, and it was just such a great experience. And that sort of song reminded me of that trip.
Maybe we could call
Yeah. You want to give him a call?
Should we give on a call?
I would love to tell them about my experience.
Sure, yeah.
Oh, yeah. We can talk to someone at on. Let them know that we're live at South by Southwest.
Yeah. They would probably love the advertisement.
That would be great. We'll tell them we're live on the radio. We're going to give them some free advertising. Tell them that I just sucked on Randy's foot.
Eucalyptic tree.
Eucalyptic tree. Tell them about the eucalyptic tree.
Pardon me. I got a eucalyptic tree growing. I wondered if it would be an idea for you. Pardon me. This is Jason Ducks.
Hello, and thank you for calling Sports. If you need assistance, please press 0, and an associate would be happy to help you.
Oh, but they're closed.
Hold on, never know.
Somebody's got it.
Hi, this is Hollywood. How may I help you?
How you doing? This is Jim Dukes. Is this right here?
Yes, it is.
I thought y'all closed at 7. I was just checking in here.
No, we close at 9 today.
Oh, at 9. What a good day to stay open late. I agree with you there. Now, my question is, I'm a big fan of the eucalyptic smell. Do y'all have anything that will be a eucalyptic smell available at the store?
I can check for you if you'd like.
I'm looking for like a eucalyptic chair, maybe like an incense, something that will conjure up like a trip abroad. I just came back from a eucalyptic country. So I'm looking to kind of create a new room.
Okay, I could check it out for you on our website if you'd like.
Oh, that would be just great.
Alrighty, let me put you on hold and I'll get back to you in a couple minutes, okay?
Oh, wait, can we just stay on the phone though? Because I'm scared I'm going to get disconnected.
Oh, yeah, sure. No problem.
Okay. I'm looking for particular something in the store, though. I want like a eucalyptic item I can swing on down there in a few minutes and pick up.
Alrighty. I'm searching it up right now.
Okay, you're searching it up. That's good. I grew up on Terpsichore. You know, are you familiar with that area?
Uh-huh.
That's good. It's a sweet little heart of a place to be. The trolley run through there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
I'm a New Orleanian.
Let me ask one of my coworkers to see if we actually have something.
Okay. With eucalyptic. Mm-hmm. Say it out loud. Hello, I'm still here now.
Yeah, we don't have any eucalyptus. We only have, like, a fake eucalyptus flower.
I'm looking more for a eucalyptic. I think that's a little bit different. Do you know what I'm talking about there? A eucalyptic, it's like an autumn fashioned out of a eucalyptic, branches or leaves and flower. Well, what does that eucalyptic flower look like? Maybe you can describe it to me.
Let me search it up.
Oh, search it up. I always say search it down. That's a different way to say it. What was that, a laugh? That was a good laugh. I'm outfitting a new home.
Mm-hmm.
We're outfitting it. I just moved in with my long-term partner, and we are so happy.
Oh, that's good.
We're actually just not that far up the strip from y'all there.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's an old Craftsman. We just refinanced it and refurbished it and did all sorts of up downtown paint to it, and now we're just terribly excited about getting a movement on it. Yeah.
That sounds amazing.
you're so nice. I would love to hear you speak to my partner here. Let me get up, because he's much better at describing what the style is. He was just interposed from me. Hold on here. What's your name there?
Liz,
hold on a second here, Liz. Hey, Bretta. Bretta, come on here and say a word on the phone. So the young girl named Liz.
What's that?
Come on here, say the word. Come, I'm going to give you the phone here.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hey, this is James Brunch.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Liz.
Oh, hi, Liz.
Yeah.
Did you call here?
Yeah, he's looking for a eucalyptus.
James, I've called her.
Chair, I think, or...
Oh, yeah, do you have any eucalyptics?
We don't have anything in stock as I'm searching up on our website. And I asked one of my coworkers to see if we had anything, and he said no.
What about like an Indian type thing?
Yeah, do you have any kind of Indian eucalyptics? Like any, if it's a... Yeah, maybe an Indian eucalyptic.
No, I mean, we have like Indian stuff here, but we don't really have like eucalyptic.
Eucalyptic?
Yeah.
You getting out on that?
They said they don't have any eucalyptic.
Right.
I thought, but we got eucalyptic there before.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. I think you definitely have, because we got that chair's eucalyptic, right?
We got that chair there. What about something that got like an elephant on it?
Yeah, I think you have a eucalyptic chair with an elephant. Is there a furniture department?
Yes, but with an elephant on it.
Anything with an elephant will be just the best thing to
we just moved in together, and we're going for an elephant eucalyptic thing. I know we got that elephant eucalyptic chair from Pier 1.
We got it there, and we did.
Yeah, you guys definitely, because it is in the catalog. It's an elephant eucalyptic.
It's like a Kama Sutra kind of like.
Sometimes we get new things like shipped in, and like people purchase like a lot of things. So sometimes we may not have them in stock, or we're out of like inventory. You know what I mean?
Oh, hello there, Liz. Okay, now what were you saying now? I just picked up the phone here again.
Oh,
you said
She said they don't have a eucalyptic elephant chair, but okay, I know they do.
We already got one of them. Now what we're looking here for is something like a kind of a Kama Sutra style, like an Indian, the type the overseas, the British colony said.
I'll look at the tag on the chair.
Look at that tag there, okay. Jane. You know what I mean? Something
maybe you guys could give me the SKU number on the chair.
Oh. What is
that? It says elephant eucalyptic.
Okay.
Get our designer on.
Liz it's elephant eucalyptic.
Liz, it's elephant eucalyptic.
On elephant eucalyptic.
Eucalyptic.
With an elephant, and I'm searching it up, but I don't find it. No.
Hello?
Hello?
It says, here, read these numbers to her. Uh-huh. Tell her, here's what the tag says.
Hello,
underneath.
Liz. Hold on.
Yes?
Are you on the phone
Hold
with
on.
Her?
James, my partner James is about to read me out here to the tag to me. Now, go ahead now, James, and Liz okay. listening here.
It's mm-hmm. Elephant Eucalyptic.
Elephant Eucalyptic.
E.
E.
L.
L.
E.
E.
P.
P.
H.
H.
A.
A.
N.
N.
T.
T.
You got that?
Liz, is that, yes. did that come on through
does
there?
Does the tag have a number on it?
Oh, a number. You're looking for...
E...
Hold on. James, hold up now.
This is E-U...
James, hold up here for a minute, please.
A-L...
James. James, the young lady's asking for a number. Not a letter. Not a letter, but a number.
Okay.
James.
Oh, it's...
Liz, you have to bear with me here. Sometimes he gets his mind to something.
Yeah, one.
Oh.
And then the number one.
James, she know how to spell the name... We're
so
looking for.
I searched up.
What'd you search? Hold on, I'm listening here. Go ahead.
Okay, so I searched up our whole store, have no eucalyptus, elephant, anything, or eucalyptus scent.
What about
chairs?
What about just something that got elephant on it? Something like that, like conjures up sort of like a deep spicy. Bombay style, you know,
see
something.
See if they have anything.
I mean, we have many
on
other
it.
One second, I got
like at the store, but
Bombay.
We don't have any eucalyptus.
Did you hear that
so,
there?
Just see
yeah.
if they have anything.
Maybe
with
you guys
a deep,
should come
spicy
take a look at the
eucalyptic.
Store.
What about like a deep, spicy Bombay eucalyptic? Something like a deep, sort of like a spiciness that will conjure up like a Bombay India type feel. Anything like that. We're just trying to keep it subcontinent here.
Oh, does she want the SKU number?
She wants the SK, is that right, the SKU?
Like it's worn down a little bit.
Here we go now.
SKU is,
here we go now.
5. 79. I think that's a 0.
0.
69.
69.
22.
22.
Maybe 6.
6.
G?
G, is there a G in there? Does that make sense now to you, Leah?
Yeah, let me search
it. Okay. Oh, she's searching. Hold on. James, she's searching it up. That's the right number. She's searching it now.
Eucalyptic.
James?
So it says we have no data available.
No data.
It says that there's none in the store.
Okay.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Okay. Hold on here now. James just found another number here.
It's.
I'm going to give you the phone here, James.
Here. Hi, Liz?
Yes?
Okay. Did you said that you had the eucalyptic from that number?
No,
we still have
eucalyptus things. Like I searched up the whole inventory in the store.
Oh, that.
And we do have elephant, like Indian kind of like laid back type of stuff.
We have a chair that makes an elephant noise, but that's not eucalyptic.
Okay.
Do you have that chair?
No, we don't. I already searched it up.
Oh, did you look for the I had the SKU number on there. Did you look
I searched it up and it says that there's nothing available anymore.
I gave her the SKU. Don't you hear me?
Do you just have regular plain eucalyptic?
No, we don't. I'm sorry.
Hold on. Well, here's the chair. This is the elephant chair that makes the noise.
Hold on here. That's a blow dart. That's like the sound of a. Did you explain to her what that sound was?
I don't know if it's. I don't know if that works now.
Is that going through?
I think we just broke the chair.
Did you break? No, it's not broke. Did you break it?
I don't. Well. That's. Okay. Do you have that? Liz? That's the elephant chair.
Okay,
can you hear that?
I'm sorry. I already fixed it up and we don't have any.
Can you hear that?
Yeah, would you like to speak to our manager?
Hold on. Okay, can you hear the chair? I'm going to hold the chair up to the phone.
I'm playing the chair. I'm playing it. I'm turning the chair on. I'm playing the chair, James. The chair is blowing.
Now that's not the eucalyptus. Can you hear?
Okay, I'm turning it off now.
That's not eucalyptic though.
That's just. Hello, Liz. Hold on.
Hi, how can I help you?
Hello, sir. We're just trying to find an elephant chair here. We're playing. Is this Liz?
That, can they hear the chair? I'm playing the
chair.
I
think they can hear now. I just told her.
It's the eucalyptic chair.
It's the eucalyptic chair here with the elephant sound. Hello, sir?
We don't carry anything like that.
Okay, well,
it says, it's okay. The SKU number on it says on. It's eucalyptic.
My partner here is telling me. Would you please stop it? Turn it off. I'm trying to talk on the phone here. Hold on.
It's 100% eucalyptic.
Do you have a SKU number?
We just gave a SKU number to.
Is that the SKU on the tag underneath of the chair?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. It's SKU. It's a little worn.
6-5-4-4-7.
It's going to start with either a 1 or a 2.
I've seen it. It looks like a 2, but it looks more like a 6.
He said it's going to start with a 1 or a 2.
It looks like a 2. It could be a 6. I don't know.
He said it could be a 2 or a 6.
It's going to start with a 2 or a 1.
I see a 2. I can see it being a
2. Okay. So that's a 2 then. What is it? 2, 6?
2, 6, 7.
7.
8.
8.
Looks like a 1.
Looks like a 1.
Okay. Are there additional numbers?
It says eucalyptic.
No, it does not say eucalyptic. It's got like a 9 here. I think that says a 9. Oh, sorry.
9?
I can't read. It's too small. It's too small.
9?
The letters are too small, James.
The letters are too small for my partner to read.
If you wanted to take a look.
We could bring the chair in.
Can we bring it? I don't know if I can put this
in. Can you put the chair in the car?
We can't fit it. It's too loud.
Our car's too small for the chair.
Okay. We're open till 9 o'clock tonight, and we open tomorrow morning at 10.
Okay. How late are you open until tonight?
Until 9 o'clock.
All right.
I had to hang up on him. He's still on the line.
Oh, you hung up?
I finally hung up once we started laughing.
I couldn't talk.
An elephant noise screeching for minutes upon minutes of an elephant sound.
Eucalyptic
blasting. I can't believe how nice they were.
That's the kind of entertainment you get here at South by Southwest, Bonehead. So if you're a first-time listener.
Oh, God.
It's best to listen to the podcast while sitting in an elephant eucalyptic chair.
Oh, thanks. Jesus Christ.
Oh, boy. So so we'll figure out where to get one of those chairs eventually.
I want an elephant eucalyptic chair. And when you sit on it, it plays rain and nonstop trumpet blasts from an ancient elephant.
Oh, boy.
Oh, God.
That's just hard to come down from.
Mm-hmm.
So, Randy, I heard you're a chicken.
I'm a chicken?
Yeah.
Who said that?
I read it online.
Who said that online?
Johnny told me.
Cypress Hill blog.
Cypress Hill's blog.
It said,
I'm a chicken?
It said, I'm a chicken hawk hunting for a chicken. Something like that.
What?
Yeah.
I ain't no chicken, brah.
I'm a chicken hawk hunting for a chicken.
I'm not a chicken.
Oh, God.
Well, maybe that should just be the podcast. How long have we done?
50 minutes.
50 minutes? Yeah. That's a perfect podcast length.
Yeah. Ouch, my ribs. come on out. Ouch, my ribs.
Well, if you're here at South by Southwest, come see us at the barbecue tent.
Yeah.
Johnny's cooking up some of his famous ribs.
Famous ribs. They've been cooking now. They've been smoking for 17 days.
And I've been smoking my world famous eucalyptic chicken.
I just love a good joke.
What's that?
They fell off the bone days ago. You get it?
No.
Like the ribs are so tender.
They're so tender.
They fell off the bone like last week.
But that would mean that it's like, I don't want to eat week old rib meat.
Oh, you're not a real fan of barbecue, I guess. Those are two double real burps.
Double real. Yow.
Okay.
Okay, Randy, if you're not a chicken,
mm-hmm.
I want you to burp, sneeze, and hiccup at the same time.
He would die.
Burp, sneeze, hiccup.
My friend in high school died from that.
Was it colonoscopy? I don't. Randy just did it.
Wow.
I don't feel good.
Randy, you got about 20 minutes. You don't get to a doctor and quickly get some anti-venom, you're going to die.
You gotta pay a doctor to fart in your mouth.
That or you have to like blow a sack of wheat germ up your ass.
Yeah.
Up your ass.
Up your ass.
It's gonna neti pot your ass.
A neti pot your ass. Johnny, is there anything you want to promote?
I got a new episode of Twisting the Wind that's gonna drop tomorrow.
Where can people hear that?
feralaudio.com/twistingthewind, I think, or you know, iTunes, the whole deal.
So if you folks out there, if you have iTunes or Twisting the Wind, you can download Johnny's podcast called Audio Feral.
It's great. You're gonna like this episode because I talked to a guy at the TSA.
Can't wait to hear that. Yeah. We should call the TSA sometime here.
It's actually surprisingly easy, and they will entertain the weirdest shit.
Huh.
Yeah. It was fun.
Randy, anything you want to say?
I don't
look good.
I feel good. I don't feel good.
You don't? I told him not to do it.
Yeah.
I dared him to do it. I'm sorry.
Classic. I think I got...
I don't think you're a chicken, bro.
Classic prankster.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm sorry for pranking you to death, bro.
My throat doesn't feel good. It feels all tight.
Oh, no.
The prankster.
Oh, Randy, don't die. I don't want to prank you to death.
I don't feel good.
You're my best
Listen
friend.
Listen to my throat.
No, it doesn't...
Is it my fault?
I'm going to burp, sneeze, and hiccup at the same time. I want to die, too.
I would take you up to my castle high in the sky. We would drink champagne and let the cloud roll by. Oh, I'll lock you up, all the windows and the doors, post a thousand guards on every floor, to dress you up like kings should do. They can have all my kingdom if they leave me. That's the thing that I would want if I were a king. Baby, it's true, all that I want of you. Oh,